from goal model to represent the higher level of system vision. In this course, you will also learn on the business process model or BPM, where swim lane diagram is one technique that will be exposed to you to model the workflow of the business of an organization. If you can recall, in topic 2, system and system context, one of the system context object is business process. So what is business process? So this slide and the following will expose to you how we are going to model or visualize the business model, sorry, the business process model for one organization. So it is well accepted that all organizations have its own business activity in their day-to-day operations. So this business activity normally have the specific workflow process, where this workflow should define the series of sequential tasks that carried by who, okay, based on what or certain rule or conditions at when or specific time duration. So workflow have this information to be observed, who does what and when. So observing the current or as is workflow in the organization should help requirement engineer to identify the issues and current problems, then highlighting the improvement using the automated or IT solutions. This slide shows an example of developed swim lane diagram. You can read for more information at the given URL. Okay, so basically a swim lane diagram is one type of flowchart that represent who does what in a process at certain time. So it uses a metaphor of lanes in a pool, but in swim lane diagram, the lanes denote the specific roles or stakeholder or actor of a particular employee, group of people or the departmental that perform a series of sequential tasks or the process. There are many flowchart symbols that can be used in swim lane diagram as well. So you can observe that the input, output, the process, okay, and the decision is the common symbols that being used in swim lane diagram as well. So this is the general stage or steps in modeling the business process. Okay, so in observing the business process for organization or the specific workflow, first we have to frame or identify the main process. Okay, what are the existing as is process conducted or performed by the employee in the organization? Okay, so that will be the second, understand as is or the current process. Okay, then from the current or the as is process, we need to propose the solution. Okay, the propose is basically 2B that provide the solutions, provide the improvement to the legacy or existing processes. Okay, then we will further develop the use cases from the business process modeling. So in this slide, it shows the current or as is dengue prediction operation swim lane diagram. So only one role involved in this process of dengue prediction operation, namely the entomologist. So you can observe that the symbol of start and similar to flowchart implementation. So the input, okay, the output, the documentation, Okay, and the external system that collaborate or integrate with this current dengue prediction operation is also stated. This is how the swim lane diagram being constructed for the real system. Okay, but this one is for the current process of dengue prediction operation. So you will be also asked to develop a swim lane diagram for the 2B or for the proposed automated dengue prediction operation. So you may observe that in the 2B swim lane diagram, the previous role is only one, but in 2B system or 2B swim lane diagram, we have two roles. So the first role is the one specific actor named as entomologist, but the second roles is the EPET here is the system, the proposed system. So the actor entomologist will interact with the proposed system in performing the dengue prediction operation in overall. Okay, in this video we already covered on topic 4 part 1 on the introduction to the model based requirements documentation. Okay, what are the benefits of delivering or documenting the requirements using model based, and you've been also exposed how to model the system visions using high level objective of goal model, and you should know how to decompose further the goals to the sub goals using AND or decomposition. Okay, and lastly you being introduced to the business process modeling using swim lane diagram. Okay, where we have this swim lane diagram for us to observe the current workflow or current business process that being conducted in one organization, and later on we develop the future or the proposed 2B workflow for the developed system.